Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Dr. Siddhi Goyal. I'm here to present my free paper titled Assessment of ICL Vault Using a Posterior Segment OCT. There are no financial disclosures. So I'd like to introduce by discussing about ICL, which is the implantable collamer lens. It's a type of a posterior chamber phakic IOL, which is used for correction of myopia as well as hyperopia. I'd also like you to understand what is the ICL vault. It is the space between the posterior surface of the ICL and the anterior surface of the crystalline lens, and we target an ideal vault of 250 to 750 microns. So this is a slit lamp image which shows us the ICL vault. Here if we see the space between the yellow arrows, that is the asterisk, is the ICL vault. And this is the corresponding anterior segment OCT which we routinely do in our post-op patients to assess the ICL vaulting. So why is vaulting important? Excessive vaulting that is greater than 750 microns, which could result as a result of larger sized ICL and can lead to angle crowding in glaucoma, which we can again see in the image that is presented down. And insufficient vaulting, which is less than 250 microns, which could result as a smaller size ICL and can lead to increased risk of cataractogenesis and pigment dispersion. So, the aim of a study was to correlate the ICL vault between a standard anterior segment OCT and the modified posterior segment OCT. So, how did we modify the posterior segment OCT? The routinely used posterior segment OCT was modified by placing a 20 diopters biconvex lens along its scanning aperture. This adjustment is able to scan the anterior segment structures by inducing extra convergence, thereby allowing effortless imaging of the anterior segment structures right from the corneal apex to the posterior capsule of the lens. So this is just an image. We see the examiner's view of the posterior segment OCT that we used, and this is the scanning aperture where we have secured a 20 diopter lens using a micropore. Thus, 16 eyes of 8 patients underwent vaulting assessment using the standard AS OCT as well as the modified posterior segment OCT. So, coming to the results, the mean age of 8 patients that were included in our study was 26 years. The mean ICL vault as seen on AS OCT was 586 microns, whereas on the modified OCT, it was 596 microns, which resulted in a mean difference of 9.8 microns, which came out to be statistically significant. However, this minute difference could be attributed to subtle deviations in the selection points or any other unknown errors. This is a representative image which we acquired on the modified posterior segment OCT. Here, as we see, the yellow arrow represents the posterior surface of the ICL and the red arrow is the anterior capsule of the crystalline lens, and the distance between these two represents the ICL vault. These are similar images which were acquired in the other patients and how we calculated the vaulting. Also, I would like to just highlight a study from our center, which was again for ICL vaulting, which we use a smartphone macro lens combination for ICL vaulting. It was a simple tool to assess the ICL vault. Here, as we see, there's a macro lens which was clipped onto a camera, a routine phone, and then this is the anterior segment slit lamp image that we acquired through this combination, and a magnified image of the same, which was we use the ImageJ software to calculate the ICL vaulting. Thus, I'd like to conclude by saying, on posterior segment OCT with simple modifications, ICL vaulting can be quantified with great accuracy. Therefore, this modality is a no-cost modification and can be used as an alternative tool in place of AS OCT during post-operative period. It is a simple and inexpensive modification which can be used as a comprehensive ophthalmic imaging tool for both anterior and posterior segment evaluation. The limitation of this modification is the lack of the ability of the machine to image the anterior chamber depth in one scan. Thank you.
One or two comments.
Yes.
Number one, I think it is mentioned in the guidelines that you should not mention your institute while doing a presentation, especially if it is to be counted for a marking. That's okay. Number one. Number two, for all the contestants, we have indicator in your thing. So if you want to show, you can actually show that. And this concept of introducing a plus 20 lens to OCT has been presented previously in various presentations. And this sounds to be a very good idea. And what you showed with your this smartphone thing,
yes, sir.
I think we are heading towards that AI thing for which actually you are going to incorporate these lenses in the smartphone itself.
Right.
So actually you can do your auto photograph. So we should not be very happy about it because it's going to take some of our work out of it. So be very careful. I think it was a nice presentation. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Doctor, how many cases you did it like this?
There were 16 eyes, 8 patients we included at one point in time whenever they came in the follow-up period. So we compared both the modalities together, ASOCT and the modified OCT.